what we're doing, all perfectly legal, exactly compliant with the law, and then it gets uptaken in fish, it gets uptaken in our drinking water, it gets uptaken in the water we use for our irrigation.
Was there a study that showed that hormones in the water is leading to what we would call transgender fish?
Well, I don't want to call it transgender fish, but I will call it intersexual fish. One recent study had 19 rivers, and they found that there was a very high level of male fish that were now growing eggs from the estrogen. The only reason that would be from the estrogen that is getting into the water. Now, some of that comes from birth control pills, some of that comes from animal feed, some of that comes from other natural sources. Now, whether it has an effect on a human gender selection, that's a bridge too far, but there are people, not me, but there are people who have a suspicion that that may be the cause.
We have federal agencies that we have paid billions of dollars to for this very purpose. I mean, there are a few things more important probably than protecting the safety of our water supply. So how has this been allowed to happen?
Frankly, Cheryl, this is precisely why I wrote this book. It is not to write a book. It is to hopefully to launch a movement where people will say, I demand better oversight, I demand better drinking water for myself and for my children.
Segal says there is something the federal EPA should be doing, mandating use of technology to filter out these contaminants. He says it exists and isn't terribly expensive, it's just that hardly anyone is using it. One place that is, Orange County, California. Coming up on Full Measure, Hillary Clinton.